بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. First we have to open a new part file. Then select a plane which you want to sketch. Then go to the sketch. Just simply draw a circle. Then select a line. Draw intersecting lines. After that you have to just go to dream entities. Just delete the unwanted segments. Apply the fillet at the sharp corners. Specify the radius value in the fillet. Then click OK. After that, go to exit sketch. Then go to the surfaces. Select the extruded surfaces with corresponding sketches. Add a taper for extruded surfaces. Specify the degree value and draft outward. Give the degrees value based upon your requirement. Then click OK. After that, you have to select a mid plane. Drag the mid plane for required size. Make it to the normal view. Then go to the sketch. Draw a center line for references, which is must necessary for a revolved surface. Then we have to draw a circle. Then go to the dream entities, just delete the unwanted segments, exit the sketch, go to the surfaces, select a revolved surface. Now this revolved surface is created here, just click OK. Again you have to draw some extruded surface at a mid plane, so select a corresponding mid plane. Then you have to go to sketch, draw a line here, draw an inclined line across the ball shaped structure, then exit the sketch, go to the surfaces, select a extruded surfaces, make it at a mid plane and specify the amount of length value here. Just click OK. After that we have using a dream surfaces. Make sure it in a mutual dream type. Select all surfaces and select corresponding remove selections. Then click OK. Then we are going to use loft surfaces. We have a two profiles here. So select two profiles. While selecting a second profile, we have go to selection manager and select a group entities. Then select a second profile. Just click OK after that. The loft surface is created here. We have to change the start and end constraints to the tangency to the faces. We have to apply the tangency value based upon your requirement to get a helmet shape. We have to increase some tangency value here. The corresponding changes is appear on surfaces. After give the specified amount of tangency, you just click OK to the loft surfaces. After give the corresponding values, we have to make some changes on values of tangency faces to get the regular update shapes. After that, just click OK. Now our helmet outer surface is created here. Then again select a midplane and draw a profile by using a spline. Drag the drag points to get the flexible shapes of spline. Just click OK. Then exit the sketch, go to the surfaces, then select the extruded surfaces, extrude the spline for required length, specify the directions, then click OK. After that, we are going to use rim surfaces to achieve the shape of helmet. Just go to rim surfaces. Make sure rim type in a mutual conditions, select all surfaces, and then you have to select a remove selections with corresponding surfaces. Now we are getting a successful shape of helmet. After that, just hide the surfaces which we are extrude here. Now we are achieve the shape of helmet. After that, you have to give the appearance color for the aesthetic look of helmet based upon your requirement. To get the regular updates of my video, please subscribe in my channel. Don't forget to like and share. Inshallah, we will meet in next video. Thanks for watching.